Wow, what a time to be alive. Usually, industries change gradually over time, but because of coronavirus, you're seeing Hollywood drastically change right before your eyes. And Disney, oh, Disney just did a game changer. This is incredible. It looked like Netflix was the industry leader when it comes to streaming, but I think Disney just seriously pulled ahead. Unless this doesn't work. But I think it's gonna work. This is incredible. We have so much to go over. Don't worry, by the end of this video, you'll get all the information that's available right now. All right, so for a minute there, it looked like there would be no news out of today's quarterly earnings report, especially after Bob Chapek, the new head of the Disney company, announced upcoming shows on Disney Plus and left Marvel out. But don't worry, someone asked him about it in the question section, in the Q&A section after his comments, and he did name check Loki, Falcon and Winter Soldier, and WandaVision. Someone was like, do you think that the fall slate of Disney Plus programming is strong enough to be competitive? And then he's like, I gotta bring out Marvel. So he said, production needs to resume on all three of those shows, which means it has not yet resumed, despite some rumors that it has. But he said, production needs to resume on all three of these shows, but it's a top priority for us because we know we need content on Disney Plus. But he also said that from what he's seen of the show so far, they're all excellent. And as far as he's concerned, they're still coming relatively soon. But he wouldn't give a date. He would not commit to a date. But then he dropped a doozy during his official comments. A game changer, as I said. And something I've been telling you would be happening for months. And a lot of people not only didn't believe me, but were pretty freaking mean about it. So, ha! I have to laugh. Because, as I said, people weren't just like, I don't agree with you, but like, that's ridiculous, it'll never happen. Well, here you go. As they say, who's laughing now? This, and also, I just love the movie business, and this is an incredible development. All right, so let's break it down. Let's break down what happened today. I have to hand it to Disney. They had a $3.5 billion loss in the theme park division, and their overall revenue was down 42%. But they managed to spin this thing into a huge positive, and the future looks pretty bright for them. So I'm impressed. So as I said, Disney had its quarterly earnings call today. Anyone can listen in. And for the first time, Bob Chapek flew solo. Maybe Bob Iger didn't want to be anywhere near these bleak numbers. But still, or maybe he was just graciously passing the baton to Chapek. Who knows? I think it might have been the former. But anyway, Iger's shadow still loomed large over the call with the almost singular laser focus on Disney Plus, the one bright spot on Disney's report as the company has been basically paralyzed by coronavirus. Oh, so bad. But as I said, it seems pretty good actually with all these developments. And Disney Plus, of course, is Iger's his real legacy at Disney, since he pushed so hard not only to create Disney Plus, but to launch it earlier than the competition. First to market of the new streaming services. And by the way, Iger has a lot of competition for what was his biggest move while running Disney. They were all big, but Disney Plus is really the culmination. The cherry on top, the one also to most transform the company. As you're about to see, it's already transforming the company. I can't believe it. So yes, the big headline, of course, is that Mulan is coming to Disney Plus, again, as I've been telling you for months, but as many fans and even other reporters said would never happen. Wall Street has been saying it should happen. I've been telling you that Disney has been discussing this for quite some time, and they finally pulled the trigger. They said because they've had to delay the movie so many times, and I do believe that if a movie is delayed too many times, the studio really at some point has no choice. And if Wonder Woman gets delayed again, I think Wonder Woman will find itself in a similar situation. I think everyone will be more happy to do this based on what Disney's come up with. Oh, it's so great. We're gonna talk about that. But so when is this going down? Oh, it's so fun. This is fantastic. It's so mean. So when is this going down? Well, forget opening a week after Tenet. How about opposite Tenet? It's the same damn weekend, and that's a very crowded weekend. I had this for my notes at the end, but I'll just say it now. I think The Boys should move its premiere up a date. It's just too crowded now for that weekend. The Boys should move up a weekend. If I were them, that's what I would do if I was an Amazon. So now, Bill and Ted 3 and Mulan will be available simultaneously on streaming and in theaters, while Tenet will only be available in theaters thanks to Christopher Nolan. If I were Warner Brothers, I'd be like, God damn it, Nolan. Because if I were Warner Brothers, to be honest with you, I would push him to agree to the dual release. Because why would you risk your life to see Tenet when you could stay home and safely watch Mulan? It's not like that's the only blockbuster option on the table. It's nuts. I think this is a huge problem for Tenet, and I'm very curious to see what they decide to do. The fact that Disney would open the same weekend is so aggressive. Disney, you never disappoint. I love it. It's so much fun to cover, but it sucks for Warner Brothers again. Now, movie theaters are obviously going to be quite unhappy about this. And now you can see why Universal was so happy to lock down, AMC was so happy to lock down Universal's promise of a 17-day theatrical window exclusive. Now the Universal's probably like, why did we agree to that? Because Disney has now set the tone. Disney has set the precedent. And I think Disney just KO'd that plan. Maybe that's one of the reasons Disney did it. Maybe that was the final straw, why Disney decided to send Mulan to Disney Plus. And in a very interesting way, as we're about to discuss, because they were like, the 17-day thing, we're going to kill it. We're going to kill it, and we're going to scare movie theaters in the process, because they're getting a little too big for their britches. And they did it! I wonder who came up with this. Was it Chapek? If he did, this is a pretty sweet opening move at the beginning of his tenure at the head of Disney. I mean, Orion is doing it with Bill and Ted 3, but Orion's not going to set a precedent. So if you want to watch Mulan at home, you can only do it if you're a Disney Plus subscriber. And it's not included in your subscription. Because now, unlike any other streaming service, which have all been a subscription model, and then you get everything that they offer for the one low price, Disney Plus has now created an upsell option, a potential game changer in the streaming business. Everyone will add one if this works out. Everybody, it's amazing. Because for $29.99, you can unlock Mulan on Disney Plus. Oh my God. There's no word if there's a time limit for how many times you can watch it once you do unlock it, although for $29.99, that's not the $19.99 that Universal has been doing. That's purchase price, in my opinion. But you won't own it. I guess you'll be able to watch it maybe as many times as you want on Disney Plus. And so far, Chapek has said that this will be available in the U.S., Canada, New Zealand, and a number of other countries. I'm sure the list will be coming soon. You gotta love Disney. It's a brilliant, aggressive move, like everything else that the company does. And they get not only the subscription price from you, but $29.99 on top of it. The money's just gonna come rolling in. And I know that's a lot for one or two people, but for a family, that's a huge amount of savings. And I suspect that many of the people who have Disney Plus are families. It also creates a model going forward for them to use for other big blockbusters. Now, Chapek has said, don't worry, we have no plans to do this for other movies. Emphasis on plans. But he did say, he couldn't help but say, I'm very interested. This is what Bob Chapek said. I'm very interested to see how many new subs we get with this plan and how many people will pay for it. So that means that if you subscribe to Disney Plus and you get Mulan for $29.99, you might see more movies go this route. This is amazing. So amazing. Disney Plus only jumped about 5 million subs in the last quarter, but I think it's going to go up much faster now. How many of you have Disney Plus? How many of you will pay the $29.99 for Mulan? Who wouldn't? I think anyone would, quite frankly, if you love movies. And then also, if you don't have Disney Plus, will this make you get Disney Plus? That's amazing! Chapek has also said that there will be an event in the near future to go over their streaming plans that are being changed because of this current situation. And hopefully we'll get some firm dates on the Marvel Disney Plus shows at that point. Right now, again, Chapek only highlighted already announced upcoming Disney Plus shows, The One and Only Ivan, The Right Stuff from National Geographic, and Leonardo DiCaprio, by the way, although now he's at Apple. And also The Mandalorian, of course, season 2, still set for, I think he said October, but he definitely said fall. Overall, as I said, Disney Plus revenue was down 42%, while theme parks took a particularly big hit. But it wasn't too bad because TV networks, of course, everyone's at home now, the second biggest, it goes theme parks in terms of revenue for Disney. It goes theme parks, television, and then movies. But television was up. Because of the Last Dance and stuff like that, even though, of course, they haven't had any sports, although they did just kickstart the NBA, which is taking place at Walt Disney World. Well, anyway, what are you going to do the weekend of September 4th? This is amazing. Will you go see Tenet? Were you planning to see Tenet? Does this change your plans? Will you see everything? I think the boys really needs to move up a weekend. Share your thoughts down below. Subscribe today. And, of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.